Hi everyone. I just watched Legend of Korra Book 4's fourth episode, and in this video I'm gonna go into some of the points a little further. So enjoy. So Ikki, Jinora and Milo just landed. I don't know where, but somewhere well higher up, and Jinora's trying to meditate, and then this happens. Ikki is.
Did you get through to Korra? Tell her I said hi.
Just.
Do you feel anything yet? What's taking so long, Ikki? I can't concentrate if you keep talking. Why don't you go play with one of those spirits?
I totally understand it from Ikki's point of view. Like, she's just being there, and Jinora has to meditate. Milo has gone off to God knows who because he had to pee. Well, and she's just waiting there. So yeah, it's kind of boring for her, I guess. But for Jinora, this is really, really hard because she's trying to meditate and try to feel Korra's energy, but she doesn't, and then she gets disturbed the whole time. Like, it's frustrating, but I liked how they did it. So yeah, that was a really good thing they did, in my opinion. So yeah, and then we get to the poor part where Milo meets this girl, and I think it's adorable. Also, I think the girl looks really nice.
I guess so.
She's pretty.
I'm on a top secret mission to find the Avatar. Have you seen her? I haven't, sorry. Top secret mission, huh?
Yeah. Like, oh my gosh, Milo, are you...
I've seen some things.
You're 8.
What kind of things?
Like...
crazy things. Cool.
What?
I'm neat, Will. What should I call you other than beautiful? I'm too...
Where did he learn that? Like,
Milo found a girlfriend. Go away,
Ikki. I love this scene, how Milo is trying to be a man and Ikki is just like, yeah, we gotta go. Oh my gosh. I think it's precious, but I'm not sure if I like how Milo is kind of being sexist. Like, even though they're your sisters, they're girls, who cares? Like, you've always been a pretty sweet guy with humor, and right now I'm just like, I think he's kind of annoying, and I don't like that. So I really hope that that will change. And the picture is coming back from Korra and Aang, but they don't say anything about Aang's picture, so I'm just like, yeah, somewhere inside me, I'm like, I wish they would have let Jinora, Ikki, and Milo respond to Aang's picture being there next to Korra's, so yeah. Seriously, I feel their pain because I'm like, Milo, you changed, and I'm not sure if I like it, but we'll see. Yeah. Let's go to the next part because I can go on and on about this forever, but that's no fun, I guess. And we got to the part where Toph comes in again, and yes, I'm still so happy that Toph is back, and even though this will probably be the last episode I will see her, because I think it is, but I loved it, and wow, I didn't even know that I missed her so much, apparently, but I did, so.
What's the plan for today? You're looking at it.
And she still didn't change a bit. Like, she's still being lazy. Even though she can really work hard by earthbending, she's just being lazy and just be like, I'm gonna do whatever I want. And she's bringing back up memories because Korra asks her about it.
It was hot. I was on a blimp. And I think a giant turtle showed up. Wow, what a day.
And you expect these huge stories and she's just like, yeah, this happened, that happened, and that's it. Like, oh, I love how they portrayed her. It's so tough, and I'm really happy about it. But also, the underlying meaning about, I mean, Toph knew about what was going to happen, so yeah, that was really nice. Also, I'm not gonna go too far into that. There's this part, Milo threw their food into the water or somewhere close to the river because he's like, yeah, we have to hunt for our food. Milo, I think you should get a history lesson because your grandfather, Katara, Sokka, and Toph didn't always hunt for their food. They also went to villages and bought food. So you don't have necessarily have to live completely off the wild. But anyway, I thought it was funny that they put it in. So let's go to the next part. Okay, so we get to the point where two guys from the Earth Kingdom or Earth Empire have gotten her, and they got her tied up onto a chair. They try to find out where her brother and sister are. And I think she plays it really well. I think Ikki is a pretty amazing actress. Although there is some honesty in her story. But I really feel that she is playing them by being extra extra sad, like, oh my gosh, and they're so amazing and they left me behind. She does it and she knows that she can get information out of them by doing that, and I think that's really smart. So I think I know Ikki is a very important part of the family as well, so and that they go a little bit further into it with her, I think that's amazing, because they also kind of focused on Milo and Jeanora in the past. So it's nice to see a side of Ikki too. And yeah, that she's just commanding them like, yeah, throw me one of the macaroons. That's amazing. It's, yeah. Korra in the swamp. I'm just gonna hit play and let it play while I'm going in on the scene. I thought that this was really, really interesting, really deep also. We already knew that the swamp can play some really nasty or really weird tricks on your mind, and this is again an example of that. I think they did a really good job on it. And the fact that she is clearly still dwelling on the past and her past enemies. Well, I think a lot of people in the fandom already made a lot of metas about it. That each villain had their ideals. And not everything about the ideal was wrong. And Toph later explains that too. They were villains. They truly were, because they took their ideals way too far, and they didn't see that they were doing it wrong. Like, in their minds, they truly believed that they were doing good, that what they did was good for the people. And Because Amon wanted equality. Well, that's amazing if you want equality, but he did it the wrong way. He took it way too far and got out of balance. Well, the title of book four. Woohoo. Then we've got Unalaq. He wanted the spirits back, and that's not per se a bad thing, but the way he wanted them back, and the fact that he wanted Vatu back, well, that's not a really good thing. And then of course we got the Red Lotus. They wanted freedom, and that's absolutely not a bad thing, but gaining freedom by killing people and throwing out all the rules and all the laws, well, it wouldn't work. So I think it's nice that they put it in like this so Korra could learn from it. And it's also kind of a great example for in real life. Like, there's so much behind people's actions. It's not just what they do, just the idea behind it. And even though you think like, well, that's insane, or that's just stupid or bad, just think about it. For them, it might be n really logical, and the meaning is good, but yeah, the way it turns out isn't. So okay, I talked enough. I've got more than 10 minutes to go of the episode, so we'll skip to the next part. See you then. So Milo and Jinora kind of saved Ikki, and by the way, I love the squirrel, the flying squirrel being. Like, I think it's adorable. And I also like that Ikki stands up for herself, and she should, and I really mean it. I'm proud of her. I like Ikki, like, yeah, I really like her, so yay. Okay, I'm just gonna let it play again. And so here we get to the point that Toph comes to find Korra. Here come the wise words from Toph to Korra, and I really, really, really love this scene, because I mean, there is truth in it, and I think it's amazing how they showed it. I just really, really like the scenes with Toph in it. Toph is really different in mentoring from Katara, for example, but her way works as well on a different aspect of Korra. Katara has been the calm and understanding, supporting, while Toph is being like, okay, don't be such a wimp, let's go work on it. And she's tougher, more tough on, well, haha, she's tougher on Korra than Katara. But in that moment, it's exactly what Korra needs, and she is just directly and to the point, like, that's what you need. You don't get the visions for nothing. It's because you're indeed dwelling on the past, and you can go on if you keep going back into the past, what has been already. You have to move on. And the way she tells Korra, it makes Korra realize that it is, in fact, true. I think if they kept trying to tell her that being patient and understanding and comforting, like, maybe she wouldn't even take it and be like, yeah, just stop, just let me be and whatnot. So I think, yeah, this is a really nice way to make her realize things. And I'm gonna skip to the next part because this video is already 15 minutes long almost, so see it in the next part. So we got to the Bending Grove tree, and first of all, the scenery is just breathtaking. Major compliments to the people working on the background. I have to admit, when she saw disconnected to your to the people who love you, I had to think about Sami right away. But this, oh my gosh, in the previous video, I'm sorry, I apologize for that, but I screamed and I was just like, oh my gosh, this was epic. The way they portrayed it, to me, it was perfect. I got teary-eyed. I'm not sure if you saw it, but I seriously got tears in my eyes. And I'm just like, my babies are all together and Korra's going back and, that's so, and she had tears running over her face like, oh my goodness, that's so beautiful! Oh! And they're so, oh my gosh, they're so adorable, and I loved this scene. But also, the three of them realizing that they all worked together to find Korra. Each of them had a purpose, even though they didn't realize it yet. Also, Milo's just picking his nose, but he realizes that it's tough. It cracked me up, but it was beautiful. So yeah, this video is gonna be way too long, and I apologize for that. I'm just gonna skip to the end because that's the more important stuff, I guess. Although wait, it's already going there. This scene. It's so deep, it's so beautiful, and again, I've got goosebumps, I've got the chills from this scene, and it's so powerful. She does it all by herself, bending the metal that's still inside of her body, bending it out of her, and I didn't know it all by myself. I had a little help by someone on Tumblr, but apparently it's Tai Chi, and I think the movements are so, it's so cool, those movements, and I'm totally like, yes, that's it fits so well, and oh my gosh, I'm so proud of her. Like, when you see these tiny little drops and coming out of her skin, it's super creepy, but at the same time, it's wow, I'm so proud of her. Like, she did it, and she did it all by herself. Not tough, she did it all by herself, even though it took her quite a while. And Milo, Ikki, and Jinora are just like, they're so proud of her, and she's in the Avatar state, and I'm losing it. Like, oh my gosh, our babe, our Korra is back, and I'm so proud of her, and I'm so happy. This episode was absolutely amazing. I loved it from the beginning to the end, and just, oh, my heart, wow. So, I feel like this video is way too long, but I have no regrets the way I did it, because I got to all the points that I wanted to go on into a little further, and I hope you don't mind, guys. Just, I hope you all enjoyed the episode just as much as I did. Please let me know what you thought of my video and the previous one. Any tips, recommendations, whatnot, just let me know in a reply, in a comment, on Tumblr, on YouTube. I don't... Just do whatever you like. If you wanna subscribe, awesome, great. If you don't, that's fine too. I mean, do whatever you like. I just, the last thing I'm gonna say is see you next week, guys, and I'm gonna upload the videos right now. So, bye, thanks for watching, bye.